by the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry. All who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send?
Yeah. should be standing on it.
I'm supposed to take a come on.
Alright.
I'm trying to take a picture. Be nice. Just keep moving. I'm gonna take action shots.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, video.
Just keep acting.
I hope you know what that looks like.
Spinner. Spinner. She's such a beautiful lady.
Jesus washed the disciples' feet. This was a task given to the lowliest of slaves. And Jesus used this occasion to share his love further with his disciples. When we are willing to serve others with humility and treat everyone with respect regardless of their status, we share God's greatest blessings and love with them.
Passover meal, Jesus broke the bread and presented the wine, introducing a new covenant between God and his people. Just as he did with the disciples, Jesus calls us to his holy table and invites us to be in communion with him, saying, "Take it and eat it, for this is my body. And each of you drink from it, for this is my blood, which seals the covenant between God and his people." As Catholics, we believe Christ is really, truly present in the Holy Eucharist. It is nourishment for our souls and gives us strength to draw closer to him.
In the final hours before Jesus' arrest, he took three of his disciples to the Garden of Gethsemane and asked them to wait with him while he prayed. Jesus knew that only through fervent prayer would he find the physical and spiritual strength to withstand the agony awaiting him. Jesus did not give up, but instead, God gave him the strength to help him what he needed to complete his mission for what he had been sent to earth. God remains with us through all of our pain and trials as well. We only need to ask for what we need, and he will give us the strength we need to move forward every day.
For a mere 30 pieces of silver, Judas betrayed Jesus. With one man's decision, the fulfillment of Jesus' purpose on this world was set in motion. At times, it is so easy to be like Judas. However, we are called to be different, and to realize that money and other material things do not bring contentment. The truest form of happiness that we are capable of achieving as humans is accomplished through remaining in faith, consistently trusting in Christ, and using our gifts to meet the needs of others, as we have all tried to do throughout this week.
strips of cloth represent the blood that Jesus shed and the physical pain that filled him after his arrest, as he was whipped and beaten for our sake. Christ suffered in silence, regardless of the injustice of his treatment, because his love for us was so great. In return, he asked that we love him, live for him, and share his love and example of peace with all those we encounter.
Though we are not among the Roman soldiers who beat and mocked Jesus, we must be careful not to tolerate the mocking of Jesus' name, the church, or other people. We know Christ did not tolerate the mocking, mistreatment, or bullying of others. He stood up to crowds saying, "He that is without sin among you, let him first cast a stone." Christ is the perfect example for us, and we are called to be a Christ-like example for others.
A large stone was rolled across the front of the tomb in which Jesus was laid after he died. The next day, guards were posted at the tomb to prevent Jesus' followers from rolling aside the stone and stealing Jesus' body. However, no large stone or man-made plan could stop God's purpose from being fulfilled. Jesus rose from the dead and became our Savior. Early on Sunday morning, as the new day was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went out to see the tomb. Suddenly, there was a great earthquake, and the stone was rolled aside. An angel of the Lord came down with his face shining like lightning, and his clothing as white as snow. Then the angel spoke to the women. "Don't be afraid," he said. "I know you are looking for Jesus. He isn't here. He has been raised from the dead. Come see where his body was laying. And go quickly and tell his disciples he has been raised from the dead." During times when we feel afraid or filled with anxiety, remember the words of the angel, "Do not be afraid."
When the disciples arrived at Jesus' tomb on the third day, they did not see his body, the empty linen cloth in which Jesus had been buried. They saw, understood, and believed, for until then, they had not realized the true meaning of the scriptures that Jesus Christ would rise from the dead. Though we have not seen the physical evidence of the resurrected Savior as his disciples did, by faith, we know he defeated death and came back to life. He continues to share his love with us and lives within our hearts through the Holy Spirit.
May our faith be strengthened whenever we see these symbols of the cross and of Christ's love for us. May we be inspired by his life and invite him more deeply into our hearts as we share his love with one another. And may we feel the presence of the Holy Spirit within us as we strive to live our lives with the joy and gratitude today and every day.
Like I'm gonna break my knees. at her dad's store. She says, I'm a hard worker at my dad's store.
I'm a hard worker at my dad's store.
Good job.
She went to the father's store every day and acts out the following work projects. Painting.
Okay, honey, you have to paint now. Okay.
Painting. Washing windows.
A little bit more enthusiasm here.
You're excited to work there. You're a good worker, you know. Operating the cash register. And answering the phone. Great job.
Number two.
All right.
Yeah!
All right.
We'll get it.
Daryl steps forward. And the younger son of the wise and loving father was spoiled. He was lazy. Daryl went to the store every day and always managed to tease his sister and stick his tongue out at her every day. Stick your tongue out at her. There you go.
Hey. Number three.
Yeah!
The following directions. Daryl says, life is out there for the taking.
Life is out there for the taking.
Live for me. That's my motto.
Live for me.
Number four.
That's my motto.
But Diane said to Daryl, said that. What about your future?
What about your future?
If you don't watch it.
What? If you don't watch it.
If you don't watch it.
You will end up lost and penniless.
You'll end up lost and penniless.
Number five.
That's right!
Now the father steps forward. Diane exits. Thank you very much, Diane. And Daryl walks forward to his father. One day, Daryl went to his father. He pleaded with him that he wanted to start enjoying life today before he gets old and said to his father, please, I want my inheritance money now so I can spend it wisely.
Please, I want my inheritance money now so I can spend it wisely.
Number three.
Boo!
His father helped his son and he said, I love you so much and I hate to see you do this to yourself.
I love you so much and I hate to see you do this to yourself.
But it is your life.
But it is your life.
I'll give you your half of the inheritance if this is what you want.
I'll give you your half of the inheritance.
Done. Daryl walks to the other side of the stage and the father exits. Thank you very much, Father. Daryl went to the other side of the country to live. He searched for the perfect job that would provide him instant wealth. While looking for this job, with a well-furnished office overlooking the ocean, he continued to foolishly spend his money.
Not a good idea!
Somebody knew number six before it went up.
Yeah.
While Daryl was at the beach, living it up on his daddy's money, two beautiful girls named Lisa Luscious and Amy Airhead came up. They touched his hair. Not your own hair. Pinched his cheeks. Put their arms all over him. Dumpy man.
Roll on the ground.
There you go. And then they got up with their best pig noise. Sweet!
Sweet!
their feet, jumped up, and clicked their heels while grunting and squealing at the same time. Jumped up, clicked their heels, while grunting and squealing at the same time. You can do it. And did a hoedown dance with Darryl.
I'm glad you're home.
Let's invite your friends.